from that chest first.
It might turn into a mimic, Fred. Those things have insanely high physical or magical defense.
Nothing to steal. Oh, good god. It opened up and it's a...
Fred wreck.
Holy shit! Sweet mother of Jesus.
Let me see which one it turned into.
Do I run?
That is, I don't know which one that is. The red ones are the ones you want to be careful of, because those ones
Why
have
did I,
high,
I,
physical defense.
Riku. Okay, you know what, Tidus.
Those things Special. Will give you massive amounts
I
of
I can't run away from this fight! No!
Riku's god hand.
No, I can't flee!
Because Riku's god hand has Jillionaire on it, so Riku's god hand plus killing those mimics equals... Well, Jillionaire. It's a good way to farm for money if you have her plus steel weapon. Oh, Fred, go back to the Comlands instead, please. Get a chocobo to ride on and go to Remium Temple. Compete in the chocobo race and you get the cloudy mirror.
You can't steal from that at all.
No, you can't.
Why can't I not hit this fucking bastard? It's killing my team.
Accuracy issues, Fred.
Auron, why you gotta suck like that? I'm just gonna let myself get killed.
Difficult. Just run.
And I'm petrified. Game over. Thanks, Nyasu, for telling me to go here. Very nice of you.
I told you not to steal from that chest, Fred. I told you. I warned you about the mix.
Well, you are right. Oh, good god.
You will want...
Oh, good god. This place is not fun.
If you don't like overpowered monsters that can one-hit you, I wouldn't suggest trying the monster arena bosses. You won't like any of them. Like, for example, the video I linked you the other day with the hideous slug creature.
Yeah.
As I said before.
I will do it, but not on this playthrough.
When his HP gets down to half, he'll recede in his shell and start recovering his HP every turn.
Never should have gone there. Comlands.
Actually, I think Mace Slug was like one of the most difficult ones I had trouble with. When he receded into his shell, I summoned Anima and just had her wreck him until...
Can I go find the dude that... Can I go find the Owaka dude and buy stuff from him or not? Not anymore.
Gagazette.
The little brother dude is still there?
Yeah. He should be in the front.
Hi.
Just don't talk to one of those Yevon guys there, because he'll have Dark Anima attack you and you will not survive that. That will just be instant kill on turn one, because her attack is... Her speed is at max. All of the Dark Aeon stats are at 255, which is the max. So, you don't want to mess with those. And subjectively speaking, some people say that Dark Anima is like the hardest Dark Aeon to kill because she just has millions of health, Fred.
Shit.
It took me quite a few turns to kill her. I'd say about
maybe
50.
Oh, good god,
plus.
Chocobos are annoying.
50 plus. Oh, Fred. Chocobo training. Have fun with the salt, Fred. You have to beat the target time.
Wow, that was close. Hey!
After you finish all five of these... This is a lot of RNG bullshit, Fred.
Got an elixir. These cats, man. One
You're
more
not
time.
Gonna like the race. You have to race this lady after you finish all five of them. Getting that time of nothing on the clock is difficult.
Wow, this turd cannot go straight, Kenny.
No, even during the race to get the sun sigil, he will keep veering like this to the left and right. And then you'll also have birds flying at you to make it, they'll stagger you. And then she'll pass you, but it's not even really... You have to, basically, Fred, to get the sigil, you have to beat her in the race and get a time of nothing on the clock.
Wow.
The chocobo race at Remium Temple is easy. All you have to do is run around the spiral in a circle and get to the bottom first. You have to race against another chocobo, and it's pretty easy to beat. Collecting all 5 chests and then beating that chocobo is kind of a difficult.
Tori says that you don't have to get it in the race.
No. The mirror is, you go to Remium Temple, and when you win the race against the chocobo, you get the cloud mirror, I believe. To upgrade it to the celestial mirror, you have to beat Belgamine by having all of the Aeons, because she will give you the flower crown and the scepter, which you need for the Magus sisters. And I believe that's also, you need something from her to upgrade it to the celestial mirror.
Okay.
And you can't do that because you didn't get all the destruction sphere treasures. But it's okay, no pressure on that.
I'll get that on a new save, probably. You can control the chocobo in race.
Yeah, you can, but dodging the little birds is difficult. You can hug the side of the wall for most of the race, though, to get it. Basically, Fred, you start from the,
Can I not go to the Xanarkand Ruins to grind out levels? Because this is slow.
Yeah, you can. No, I was saying to go here to go to Remium Temple, talk to the lady, and get a chocobo, and then go up to where that broken bridge was, where the feather is, that you first found when you come in there. Basically, the race against that lady for the sigil, or whatever the weapon, starts at the entrance to the, ruins, and then it ends at the exit where you go to that bridge at.
Oh, good god. Oh, thank you
for
healing.
I've done it once before, we'll never do it again.
Not even for me?
This is one of the most frustrating to get besides Lulu's, in my opinion, and maybe Kamari's, but Kamari only because of the stupid butterfly minigame, because what the actual fuck? Like, I can't even with Kamari's. Like, seriously? Let's play a butterfly catching game just to make him OP. Yeah, no, okay. Let's not and say we did. Actually, I think for Kamari, what I did was, since I didn't want to get his weapon, I made him a weapon with break damage threshold. Because fuck that. I'm not one of those, like, I don't know how to say it in a non-offensive way, but I'm not one of those shweddies, so I don't try to go all out for things that I can't be bothered to do. I will try a few times, but then if it starts to get me, like, I don't know, if I start to get angry, then I just give up, because I'm not going to stress myself out over it.
If I want to get a platinum or a 100%, I will do everything I need to do. Oh, good god, this place looks amazing.
I've said this a billion times, I don't care about platinuming games.
Well, I do.
It has nothing. I see it as nothing, as a testament to your skill in a game. You can have the platinum trophy for the game and still suck at it, in my opinion.
Well, the games that I have platinumed or 100% either on Steam or on PSN, I'm pretty good at them. Like Binding of Isaac, Rogue Legacy, Dark Souls, Bloodborne, Destiny-ish, I guess. I don't know. So what do I do in this temple place thing?
Go to the, off to the side.
Ooh, there's a thing.
You should see a chocobo over there. You can go in there and fight Belgamine.
I found
you just
a sphere.
Can't do all of the fights because you don't have all of the, talk to that chocobo and you'll start the race. Just race to the bottom. Yeah, that's one of the Jekt spheres. And there's an all-bed primer in the back, Fred. It should be obvious. Oh no, this is to start the race. My bad. But yeah, there's an all-bed primer behind that sphere.
Yeah, I saw it.
Alright.
I thought that was a Jekt sphere. Now I'm disappointed.
There's one on the Mushroom Rock Road.
Why can't I not?
I think you need a chocobo out there to get it.
Why can't I not? What? What? Huh? What do you want me to do with those chocobo thing beasts?
I think you have to go to the other side, Fred. Go talk to the one
on
the
way.
Left side, or the right side.
It seems to be telling you to
ride
it.
You have to race him to the bottom.
That is kind of disgusting.
If you open all the chests, you get an achievement, but I wouldn't be bothered with it right now. You just want the mirror.
Do I just open the chest and don't worry about racing?
No, worry about racing. Don't open the chests.
Oh, well, I opened the chest.
At least not right now. The chests are only for an achievement in some good to mediocre items. You can grab a few, but I really wouldn't.
Well, that thing passed
the
other
bottom to get the cloudy mirror.
The chocobo passed me, so stop going that way, you idiot.
Yeah, you have to go down, Fred.
Okay, that's where I have to go. Like, that's the thing. I don't know where to go. Now I know where to go.
Well,
so
if you lose, just keep practicing it.
Yeah,
actually,
but I know where
to
go
open
now.
All five chests and not hit those little poles, I believe, for the achievement.
I'm gonna win this race now. Like, with ease, actually. You win. Cloudy Mirror. This item opens ancient seals hidden throughout Spira. It seems to have lost its power, but there might be a way to restore it. And how do I do that?
Hold on. You have to talk to the mother at the entrance, mother and son at the entrance of Makalania Woods, Fred.
Okay. Hang on, let me check out this temple first.
Basically, I believe you can get the celestial weapons, you just can't get Anima. And you can't break damage limit with some of your Aeons.
That's okay.
If you don't have the celestial
weapons.
Oh
god, there's that bitch again.
You have one for, you can
what
break damage
place?
Limit. Yeah,
Rimium
you have
temple.
To fight her.
Once a
if you fight all of her Aeons, she gives you the flower, crown, and scepter for
sin.
The Magus sisters, which are basically the faith
home?
Of this temple.
What?
Or
you
the
got
Aeon,
something
rather.
Against company? It's a long story. Easier, perhaps, to show you. You're dead, too. Don't send me just yet.
Oh, this woman is dead?
There's still one thing left.
Okay.
Yes, Fred. She's unsent. I was gonna tell you that the other day, but you said no spoilers, so.
Might just be able to defeat Sin.
Well, I pretty much chopped Sin up already, so.
I challenge you. If you cannot beat me, you'll
not
never
yet. You didn't
Sin.
Defeat Overdrive Sin.
That's a detail. Fail four.
Very well. Now,
I should have overdrive readied these things now, shouldn't have.
Basically, Fred, remember back in the Makalania Woods, where that big weird-looking plant is that looks like the Sin Spawn up on the sparkly road?
Choose
in order to get that lady
something.
To move, you have to find her husband, and then after you find her husband, you have to do a stupid side quest to find her son. And then when you find her son, she moves. And then
okay.
You go talk to the plant, show it the mirror, and then it will turn into the celestial mirror. When you have two sigils, when you have a sigil, a crest, and anybody's underpowered celestial weapon, you'll be able to upgrade them twice.
Yeah, I found that secret path because I went that way.
The first time it will have, I think it only has no AP ability, but once you level it up the second time with the sigil or crest, it will remove the no AP gap from it. Yeah, for Titus's son sigil, you need to do the chocobo race. You can actually use the chocobo rider as a shield on that one. You could kind of stand behind, like, right behind her and sometimes you won't be hit by the birds. Yuna's Nirvana is easy and probably one of the, oh, nope, actually, you can't get hers. You have to defeat all of the Aeons at Remium Temple. You miss the Destruction Sphere treasure, so rip Nirvana. Best Celestial weapon, in my opinion, because of the 1 MP cost.
Oh, hers knows Energy Blast? Damn.
Yeah, you missed it.
Yeah, I know.
And also, the special effect is that when Yuna's MP is full for Nirvana, it allows Veilcor to exceed, it does more damage when her MP is full and allows Veilcor to break damage threshold. Every character's...
How do you know when in these fights, when an enemy Aeon is low on health?
It'll, like, slouch over.
Okay.
Kind of like Shiva, when her health is low, she'll slump forward.
Yeah, like Ifrit just now, where he was like, ooh, yeah. I'm weak.
Hey!
Kitten, split.
Her kitty shenanigans.
Yeah. They're in their play mood at the moment.
Fred?
Yes?
I'll list these for you now, since you're here fighting anyway. Veilcor has 20,000 HP. Ifrit has 28,000, Ixion has 30,000, Shiva has 20,000, Bahamut has 35,000, Yojimbo has 32, same as when you faced him in the temple, the cavern actually. Anima has 54,000, which I believe is the same that she had when you fought Seymour. But you can't fight her, unfortunately. Sad face. Magus Sisters. If there's three of them, and yes, you have to fight all three of them at the same time, Fred. It's probably one of the coolest Aeon versus battles.
Oh, shit. Rip Ifrit. Can I use more than one summon per fight, or...?
Yes, you can.
Okay.
You can use all of them until they all die.
Yeah, I know I can still get it, but it's gonna be a pain because I have to fight Dark Veilcor.
Yep. Because as soon as you try to walk into a town, the Yevon monk guy will ambush you and talk all this crap about how you're a traitor, and then he'll do like that Yevon bow at you, and then Dark Veilcor comes up and just crushes your ass. He crushes your life, your spirit, and your dreams if you're not well prepared.
Yeah, Veilcor is over less than half now. Oh,
I believe on Final Fantasy X-2 you fight one of the Dark Aeons during the course of the story. I believe it was Dark Ixion. Don't quote me on that. It's been a very long time since I played that game. I would say at least over 5 years. Fred, you should have summoned Bahamut. And for that, I am glad. Take this. It may come. He wrecks the crap out of everything, all of these, until you get to him. Because when you get to the point where you have to fight him with her, you can't use him. Which is where you would want to summon Anima if you had her. Because that's what I did.
What's this?
I summoned Anima and just crushed him like a worm.
What is this door behind her?
That's where you get the Magus Sisters, Fred. But you need the Crown and Scepter by beating all of her Aeons, which you can't do, unfortunately.
I'm not gonna waste my time
Another time, don't worry.
Yeah, I'm not gonna waste my time here. Because you don't get you don't get anything from it.
You get good items for beating her.
Yeah. Oh, actually,
Ifrit will give you 30 X potions the first time you beat him. Ixion will give you 10 chocobo feathers. Shiva will give you 60 mega potions. Bahamut will give you the Flower Scepter, which is one of the things you need. Yojimbo gives you Shadow Gem times 8. Anima gives you Stamina Spring times 60, which I believe is a very good thing.
Are you Googling this, or do you all notice?
Shiny Gem times 40 and the Moon Sigil if you perform the Far Plane send off. Basically, you have to choose to send her after you beat her to get the sigil. Fred, I have a question. Do you have both the crest for crest and sigil for Orin?
I don't. What is the sigil?
I believe his is Mars.
Yeah, but, like, I have the Mars crest, and I have the rusty sword. Shit.
Oh, actually, no, for hers, you have to, for Orin's, you have to unlock 10 special battles at Monster Arena to obtain the sigil. Or the crest sigil. You have to unlock any combination of 10 arena creations or species creations bosses at the Monster Arena, and the trainer will give this to you.
Okay.
His is one of the easiest and, at the same time, one of the most time-consuming. Besides,
Lulu's is like, man,
the biggest time sink. Sorry, it's late here and my throat hurts from talking too much. This is the downside of when you're a person who doesn't know how to shut up.
Wrong break.
Plan! Ugh, Fred. Fred. I want to show you something.
Show me something. Oh, good god. This thing knows flare.
Yup. If you think this thing is terrible, wait till you see Jumbo Flan. I believe that's the boss's name in Monster Arena.
Rusty blade should... Yeah, I have the rusty blade. There. Lulu now knows double cast. But that's a YouTube video. I don't want to watch a YouTube video.
Fred, that is a nightmare, boss. Please believe me. But at this point, Fred, you have to be careful going back to Mushroom Rock Road. Because you'll be ambushed by the Yevon guys that summoned the Dark Magus sisters on you.
Genesis, stop it. Fuck's sake.
To be honest with you. I mean, the best way to deal with them is to kill them one at a time. But you have to run from the monks or whatever you want to call them that are chasing you. And try to, you know what I mean, to keep them, like, yeah. I can't remember which ones, I killed. I know I killed the weak ones.
Okay, I'm gonna switch you with Yuna.
Which is basically, Baleport, Ifrit, Ixion, Shiva. I may have killed Anima. I don't remember.
Completely different from PS2 version, apparently. No idea.
Yes, because, if you live in America, the PS2 version of Final Fantasy X is different because we did not have the international version with the Dark Aeons and Expert Spear Grid or the Penance Super Boss Battle. Like I said, ours was far inferior on PS2. Which was one of the reasons why I wanted to, try this on PS3 and 4 because since I don't live in Europe or in any of the Asian countries, I've never got to experience the additional content on PS4, on the original version of the game. That's why that guy that came in earlier, Fred, was telling you to use the Tonberry trick for HP, AP leveling, because that's how the Americans used to do it on our inferior PS2 version. Because, yeah. But since this is the international version content, once you unlock Cactar King, you're going to want to use him instead. But you will have to have Auto Phoenix on your
overkill
weapons. I can't stress this enough. Because basically the trick is like this, Fred. You have on the, you'll need to set your, overdrive mode to the one where you get overdrive from taking damage, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you'll want to have weapons that have overdrive to AP and double or triple overdrive. You cannot stack both of those. You can only have one or the other on a weapon. And mm-hmm. to be honest, getting triple overdrive is a pain in the ass, so you're better off just using double. And you want double AP and overdrive to AP. Every time your one of your party members is hit by his 100,000 needles attack, it will convert that overdrive damage into 100,000 AP, Fred.
Damn.
And that will gain you a lot of spirit levels very fast. The reason why in the American version on PS2 it was better to do Don Tonberry was because when they ported it here, they made it so that your AP caps at a certain amount when you were using the overdrive AP trick. In the Japan and the Japanese and European versions of Final Fantasy II on PS2, on PS2, it did not have a cap. The AP wasn't capped. That's why it's the best trick.
But Automat on version, only uses it on yourself.
The best trick. Well, yeah, that's why I said you wanted it on all three characters, Fred. I'm saying you want one character to be able to cure yourself so that you can cure the other two. Because if your character is berserked or confused, you can't heal. But yeah, that's the reason why the AP trick wasn't very good on our inferior version.
Genesis, fuck's sake. Oh, this cat can be annoying.
Like I said, when they get older, they'll calm down a lot, and then they won't be doing that very much.
Yes, please. I would like it now. Oh, that's right, I have double cast.
Yeah, I would stay here in this area and kill monsters for a while. At least until they're not killing you so easily.
Well, they're only killing Yuna and Lulu pretty easily because they're just weak.
Yes, I understand.
They're very frail.
I'm confident that you can kill Overdrive Sin, but a little bit of extra training never hurts, believe me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I just wanted to make sure I have double cast on Lulu, so that's why I did it.
Yeah.
And it doesn't hurt to level up Yuna.
When you get Onion Knight for her, or a weapon that has either half AP cost or half MP cost or one MP cost, that is just the best with her.
Yeah, definitely.
I believe her Onion Knight only has half MP cost. I'm not 100% sure since I never got it. So, if I'm wrong, like I said, I don't know since I never got it. I do know for a fact that Yuna's Nirvana has one MP cost on it. Because I have that on her. I use that with a double cast. So I can double cast all of the powerful spells I know with her. Like I said, I got her almost around the entire sphere grid before I stopped playing this. So I have all of her, all of Lulu's Aga spells with Yuna. I have Flare, Ultima, Holy, so double casting those with one MP cost is just crazy. Yeah, Fred. If you're fighting enemies like this and you have the overdrive thing on so that you either have it so that when your allies take damage or you take damage to charge your overdrive gauge, it'll go up faster. Because since these things hit so hard...
Yeah, you and I have it on when allies take damage.
Yeah, that's the
everyone
best
else
way
is
to
when
do
they
it,
damage
though.
Enemies.
That's how I got a lot of AP for her though in the monster arena, doing the trick, the Cactuar King trick. Because I had her set to that, so every time Orin, Tidus, Riku, Waka, etc. was killed, she still gained AP because of the overdrive. And also because Nirvana has double AP on it, so... That message, though. That message notification. I thought you had a bird in your house when I first heard that. Long used to have a parakeet. Those things are so annoying.
Oh, I would never want to have birds. They're so fucking disgusting.
They are. That thing used to wake up at 6 o'clock in the morning and just start chattering in... Oh
no, not... I don't mean that, but... They're so dirty. Dirty birds. Like...
Parakeets are noisy as hell. They get up at sunrise and start chattering.
No use healer on Unison, she heal. Well, the problem I had with that is that Yuna's overdrive charges faster if I have it on when allies take damage compared to using it as healer, cuz I didn't have to heal all that much up until like now. So
no, he's saying don't use the healer overdrive thing for Yuna.
Don't or do?
Or she don't.
Well, he says no, use healer on Yuna since she heals. So I'm thinking that...
Oh, yeah. You probably would want to if you have to heal a lot. That would probably be the best way to go.
Well, I didn't put it on because she didn't heal all that often up until, like, the last couple of fights. Whoops.
Well, since you're... Until you're, like, to the point where you're not struggling with these enemies, I would use that.
Yeah.
I mean, it's completely up to you, but... You know
that
what
thing
I mean?
Takes like no magic damage.
Fred, this thing uses magic, so use focus. It'll negate some of the damage and then make Lulu's spell stronger. I think you can use mental break on him.
Yeah, well, yeah. I used armor break first. And this is the second time Orin gets to attack. Using double cast blasts through your MP if you don't have an MP thing, whatever.
Yes,
it is.
I know. But for overdrive sin, for the first few turns before you get close enough to attack him with physical characters, you're gonna want to keep Lulu out and double cast some of your strongest spells. Once you get close enough so that like Tidus, Orin, and Waka can attack, well, Waka can attack from far distance, but once you get close enough so that Orin and Tidus can actually
no,
go and deal damage.
No, he stole all my MP! Son of a bitch.
You will want to, use them. If you're really pressed for turns, I would say to use Yuna's Grand Summon. Do not open with Grand Summon. Save that for if you're...
Yeah, I know. It has resistance on all to all elements.
Yeah.
These things are annoying.
If you think this is annoying, you're gonna hate Jumbo Flom in the monster arena. That thing is a beast. I would say it's probably one of the hardest monsters to kill.
For real, there was a teleport thing? Oh my god, if I would have known that, I would have just teleported here because I wanted to fight in here.
Yeah. Yeah, you can teleport there.
I didn't know that.
I think you can go into the ruins now and do the puzzles for the treasure, Fred. Just don't go into the Chamber of Faith because I think you might be attacked by Dark Bahamut, but...
So this room or the next room?
No. Don't go into the room where you fought Unalesca.
Well, no, that's
not... As long as you don't go into the room where you fought Unalesca, you're fine. Yeah, this is the puzzle. You have to basically, step on all of the white squares, Fred. The white ones that used to reset.
Yeah. I'm trying to find where all of them are. This one is one. This is one.
I believe this plays the Hymn of the Faith when you step on all of the... Fred, it should be obvious. Look hard at the floor. You can kind of tell.
Not really.
Yes. Really? Kappa.
No. I need 7 white ones, but there's definitely not 7 white ones in this room. There's only like 3.
Also, Fred, it says having high luck stat will affect how often you receive a rare dropped item and how often you can make a rare steal and the rate at which you can make critical hits.
There's not 7 white
squares. I don't believe that, though.
Faded but noticeable, yeah, luck, but I have terrible eyesight.
Rate. I don't care what anyone says. That like, has been disproven.
There are not 7 white square thingies in this room.
To get Captor King, you just have to capture at least one of each monster from Thunder Plains. I still wouldn't
other room
suggest
as well.
Trying to take that thing on. I wouldn't.
It's 4.
I would like to show you sometime how I do it. How I.
Oh, good God, what have I done? No. Don't go down there. Don't go down there.
No, Fred, as long as you don't walk into the chamber where you fought Unaleska. Basically, the room where you fought her. As long as you don't walk into that room. Basically, the exact room where you fought her.
Yeah.
You got the sun sigil. As long as you don't walk in there, you're fine. Like I said, I don't know if it's you're at that point, but I still wouldn't test the waters.
Fuck. This is not a square.
You don't want to go in there and just be obliterated. Shit.
This is one. This is one. Fuck, I didn't mean to walk on that, you fucking bastard.
But yeah, Fred. Jumbo Flan is completely immune to elemental attacks. Well, no, he absorbs them, and he has high magic defense. And non-elemental spells like Flare and Ultima don't do much damage to him. I always like summoning Anima to just wreck that thing. It was the one underneath it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I noticed. Huh? For fuck's sake. I really don't like puzzles.
I do. That's why I loved this temple.
Physical is obvious.
Fred, if you don't like puzzles, you probably won't like Legend of Zelda games.
I have not played a single one.
Yeah, if you don't like puzzles, you won't like them.
It's the reason why I don't play them.
Exactly.
Even though a lot of people dislike me for that, but I don't give a fuck.
I don't judge you.
I don't play what I don't like.
Exactly, I understand that. I completely understand that. I am not going to judge you and or dislike you for your decision. Everybody's not gonna like the same thing. That just makes people boring if everybody all like the same thing.
Yep,
playing
very
the
much.
Hymn of the faith. Love this temple because of that. Well, every temple plays it, but the puzzle plays it at the end.
Now, where do I put the destruction sphere, though? Here?
You gotta go stick it in one of the slots in the room. I don't remember which one.
This one?
The left one.
The right
yeah,
one?
Left one.
The right one. Magistral rod.
Oh, thought it was the left one. There you go. This one was like the easiest destruction sphere
half
target
MP
to get
cost.
To get Anima.
Ooh.
You also had to get this one. You're gonna want to equip that to her, Fred. Screw the water, rod of wisdom. You're gonna want that one because of that half MP cost.
I'm gonna put things on that.
Of course, but...
Like right now.
The half MP cost makes it so much more worth it. It's like unless you can make one that's kind of the same as Nirvana, but not Nirvana, then that's a good one. Don't waste Sensor, Fred.
Yes. I love Sensor. I will put it on everything. No, I'm not gonna put it on everything. I put Sensor on it.
10% magic.
No, because that's spheres that I don't have a lot of. I'll be right back. I need to go to the bathroom.
You can grind for them.
Yeah, but I don't want to grind on this character is a thing. I don't mind grinding a couple of levels, but I don't want to grind items and stuff. That's what I do off stream.
Then how do you play Destiny?
That's a totally different game. That's a first-person shooter. This is a RPG.
That game pisses me off with all the grinding. In RPGs, I can understand.
Why do you think I don't play it anymore?
Yes, you do. You played it on Tuesday.
Well, that's for Touch, because Touch wanted to do the challenge mode. I help friends, because
yes,
I'm a nice guy. I'll be right back. I need to go to the bathroom before I piss in my pants. I have returned. Actually, I will be right back again. I'm gonna warm up some pizza because I'm hungry.
Yeah, I'm gonna get something to eat, so I'm probably gonna call it here.
Alright, that's good. Thanks for hanging out.
Yep.
And I'll talk to you later.
If anybody, if you need help with Sin, I would just ask in chat. I'm quite sure people will help you. It shouldn't be too hard, though.
Yeah, probably.
You can do it, Fred.
All right.
You beat Unalesta, you can do it.
Well, I'll be fine. I'll figure it out.
Yep, remember, third time's the charm.
Exactly.
Alright. I'll see you, tomorrow, later, whatever.
Alright. Later.
Yep, later.
And I will be right back. I'm gonna go grab me some pizza. I'm hungry. There we go. I have returned with some pizza. Sorry about that. I am just super hungry. And I could use some food in my body. 8 a.m. eating pizza. That's not something you see every day. Hmm. So good. Pizza is like the best thing ever. Especially if there's bacon on it.
No problem.
No cats. My food. Back off. That did way less than I expected. So good. Good dodge.
Farewell.
Nice. That was a lot of AP. Also, I really enjoy... I really like the fact that you could play this game with, like, one hand. I'm sorry if I'm not talking much, but I'm just hungry and eating. I need this delicious food in my body. God damn it. This is where we're gonna grind. Cause it's right next to next to a save sphere. So that way I don't have to worry about my MP and stuff. Plus health, obviously. Make armors with high defenses. I could do that. Overkill though. Now we can just do this and everything's healed. It's really useful. At least for now. This half MP cost thing is really nice. I'm gonna defend because there's no point in healing. Stop giving unit turns, man. Oh my god. That was some delicious pizza. Holy shit. So good. That use magic strikes? What do you mean? Here. That Machina. That use magic strength, that Machina. Don't think I get it, but I'm notorious for not being super smart. Invasion HP. Accuracy. What the hell was that? Oh my god, I think this cat is on the pizza box. Ability aim. I don't have that with Waka for some reason. The machine you just took out uses magic strikes. Ooh. Any previously activated? Any allies' location? I really need more of these teleport spheres because I want to teleport him to. Hang on, like Orin's start position. I'm still hungry. They're resistant to magical help. Still doing it? I'm still going, man. I am still going. Obviously. He fell asleep. Scroob. Hang on. Refilling a drink. Where's your holy element? She went off to sleep. She went to grab some dinner, and she's probably gonna hop, like, go to bed soon, because it's like 2 a.m. Well, it's not dinner, but something to eat. It's like 2 a.m. for her now. Yeah. It is kind of late for her, isn't it? This thing, just so I can overkill it. Later on. Dinner at 2 a.m. just like me. Well, it's not dinner. No, it's not even the water guy that I selected. I'm an idiot. Oh well. Of course, Lulu. Oh, nice. Should make sure that everyone has overdrives ready. So Riku and Tita still need overdrives. So much quieter than Yasu went to bed. Holy shit. But I have to admit, she really talks a lot when I'm about this game and Final Fantasy games in general. She really likes those games. Yeah, he means Nyasu. She's your damn guide. She pretty much is, yeah. Without her, you suck. Nah, without her, I'm just hella average. Goodbye. Actually, whoops. If I do that, I can overkill it with Auron after. Same here. I'm going back to the toilet for another 20 minutes. Be right back. Alright then. TMI, man. TMI. Too much information. Overkill? Not overkill? Oh well. Stomach aching after I woke up. The heck? Gotta get good, bruh. Gotta get good. Take a dump. Look at this song, dude. It could be showering. I highly doubt that. For some reason.
Enough.
Song, ban him. Me? Or ban Song? Cause I ain't banning Song, he's got a point. There we go, that's the big one. I need my sexy time, only toilet works. Good god, you're weird, man. You're so fucking weird. Armor break. Double cast, of course I'm gonna fap a little, stretch, shower, and fap more. Oh my god, losing. Stop being so disgusting. Plus, you're ruining my chat and the experience for the other people. They're all leaving now. It's all made up. Fap, 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 fap. Good dodge. I did a thing with you. I can do this, I guess. Really? I know, you're scaring away everyone, losing. Stop it. Plus, you're ruining everyone's experience of my chat. Please don't do that to me. I still need a hit with Kamari as well. Rip. These things still fucking hurt, man. I could power break them actually now that I think about it. Bop. Oh, never mind. He's immune to that shit. Well, he's dead. I think I got everyone. Level 2 key speeder. You know what? Fuck it, man. I can't be bothered to grind on stream when I can't listen to music and shit. So, Waka, Yuna, Lulu. Spear grid, Yuna. Oh, Jesus. Actually, now that I think about it, I should, like, grind out one more level. So I can get... nah. I'll be fine. More magic defense. And more magic. Slow. Genesis. What is it, boy? Agility. I'm gonna save. Taking a fat break.
You're counting on.
Do I go outside? I can't actually remember. Let's just see if I have to go outside. And if it is, let's hope that I can do it. Actually. Let me X out.
Thank you.
Genesis. Oh my god. It's always at the same time. It's like early in the morning when he's like, go nuts! Hey, calm down. Alright, let's go. Oh, Jesus.
Let's go. The only way is up.
Tori, thank you for the follow. Greatly appreciated. Thanks for the support. FFX is done. Welcome back, Luzon. Keep your detailed descriptions to yourself, please. That thing is so goddamn huge, man. Holy shit.
Here we go!
Yeah!
Yeah!
For you, Dad.
Dad. Alright, so... Yeah. Drawn to Sin. Song enjoyed it. I don't care what Song thinks. ...140,000 health. I should have... Oops, I can't see anything. There we go. I should have. Let's go. It's small. Okay. Should have got these overdrives ready. Well, since he is close, he smoke. Didn't you know? Thought everyone knew by now. Out of range. No. Well, you know now. I'm too uncool to smoke. Actually, do this first. Only uncool people smoke. He's immune to Demi. Shit. I am so not gonna be able to kill him. In time, I'm tempting to stream Destiny's Trials, but... Nice. I don't think the element matters anyways. Stream is too entertaining, cause those balls. Good god, losing. Good god. Want to. I'm not forcing you to stay here. Ferraga Fury. Six. All right, later to... Later, losing. Never said that. Oh shit, Waka's petrified. If only I noticed that a bit earlier. Oh well. Actually gonna swords play energy rain. Just gonna use all my overdrives. I don't think I'm gonna be able to beat him. To be completely honest. I think that doesn't work on him. If I can spam this. Oh, never mind. I'm out of MP already. Still has 80,000 health. So much. Yeah, I am not able. I am not able to beat him in time, I think. Unless the overdrive is done on a summon, then maybe. It's only two turns. I should be able to live that. $24,000 damage, holy shit, that's a lot. Okay. I am very curious as to what is gonna happen now. Watch him use his overdrive when I... Okay, never mind. I think that is his overdrive. Giga Graviton. Sounds like it's overdrive, at least. Looks fucking epic, holy shit. Okay, no, so that's just game over anyways. Okay, so... How close was I? Like 40,000 health left? Also, because Tori following, I am 5 away from 200. Which is awesome. I've said this before when I reached like 100, I think, and 150 as well. And even 50, probably. I never expected to get any following, like any sort of following whatsoever. So I'm pretty stoked with the fact... Oh, fuck, I selected no. I'm an idiot. Yes, load that save file. I think I have an idea of how to beat this, but it requires me to get all of my summons like ready to overdrive and just spam overdrives. Let me see. He's ready. He's ready. Well, she is ready, rather. She is ready. He's ready, but he doesn't really do all that much damage. Casts defensive spells on party, restores HP, water damage, camps down, two enemies do petrifies, deals damages. I don't want to use that, because that is kind of a waste of a turn. Oops. He's like... pretty much ready. Damn it. And Oren is ready. Alright. This is the fight I got stuck on as a kid as well, so... I never got past this boss. Alright. Zenarkin Ruins. Corridor. move back. And unit, actually. I'm messing with my curtains again. It's really annoying. Put Arn instead of Lulu. Yeah. The reason why I did that was because it's an overkill. Should have done that to the first one as well, actually. But oh well. I don't want to use my summons against these guys, because... Like, this guy, rather. Because, Tidus in and give him a hit so his overdrive is full. Get dark on him. And that's gonna do a shit ton of damage. Oh shit, I didn't select armor. I am actually gonna high potion Ornn. With Tidus. Armor break. Whoops. Should have healed him more, probably. Oh well. It's all good. God damn it, man. Stop being such a fucking prick, will ya? Thank you. Another level 2 key speeder. Riku's not ready yet. But I don't know what Riku is set to. I think she's set to damage. Which sucks, to be honest. Damn it. Because I don't think she's set to warrior. Nice hit. Yeah, she's set to take damage for her overdrive. Should have stolen from him and then killed him with Ornn to get overkill. But oh well. Actually, it's right here, so. I'm gonna keep Riku in for now until her overdrive is ready. And switch Waka for Yuna so I can get the summons overdrives ready. Candle of Life. I should be able to get my summon overdrive, not summon, overdrive ready on these guys. Oh. This should get me massive amounts of overdrive thingies. I'm actually gonna dismiss him now, because otherwise he's just gonna die and I don't need that. Like, I need them to live. Nice. What I can do actually is set it to boost. Boost the boost. And use the boost to get through. Because now when he takes a hit, it's gonna do decent damage, but it's gonna also like increase the amount I can of overdrive I get. See? Probably should just hit him. There you go. Ifrit's ready. And Ifrit can hit for 9, like, damage cap. Ambushed. That's not good. Raga, overkill that sumbitch. Why are they being so rude? To Riku. It's not nice. Oh shit, I'm an idiot. I'm a fucking moron. I think Veilfor can get his thing ready on this guy. Alright, Song, that's cool, man. Have a good night. And thanks for hanging out. Boost. Plus. Aw, shit. Okay, that was not as good as an idea as I thought it was. Later, Song. One more message, still 500 messages, thingies. Yeah. What's up, little buddy? Yeah, fuck. What was I thinking? Failford is gonna get wrecked by that thing, obviously. Oh, good god. Armor break. Just gonna do a prey. Dark attack. Hey. What is it? Again, dark attack. Thank you. Yeah. No! Fucking bastard. Yeah. Please miss. Oh, it doesn't matter. It doesn't kill anyway.
Farewell.
There we go. 500 messages. Level 3 keys here. No, don't heal. Just touch this thing. Preemptive strike. Block with you, block with you, attack with you for the overkill. Good job. It's probably not the best area to get overdrives for summons ready. 1, 2, 3. Another 2 mega phoenixes. I want to move you over here so you can learn. Holy. And then we can go up to, what is this? Spare chain. We can go into Riku's tree. But I would rather go like, where does Riku start? Riku starts here, so we can just backtrack up to this point and start here. Chances. What I could also do is use a teleport thing and get Yuna up here and go through this path, like all the way through Lulu's plate sphere thing. And then get her double cast as well.
Stop it.
And then look. Lulu's right here right now, so it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 more levels till she gets flare. Zoom in, please, because nice, more health, agility. I'm probably gonna use one level to get more strength and then continue on. Auron does not have that for some reason, but that's okay. It's not the worst thing in the world. How many level 3 key spheres do I have? 2. I don't think I'm gonna do that. Well, Tidus has 2 levels, but I really don't want to let him go through this path, to be honest. I'll see what I do with Tidus later. I think I am just gonna teleport him to Orin's place. Oh my god, why this stupid fucking thing, man? Switch you for Kimari. Nice. That was like one turn of darkness, huh? Those crits, man. Nice. Back to back crits from Waka. Finish it off. Nope, of course not. And then Arn will do it for you. Level 2 keys. I wish these guys dropped level 3s. This is bad. Ah, oh, shit, I didn't armor break him? I'm an idiot. Wasn't my whole plan to get this Yuna character's Aeons to overdrive? Again, the issue here is just those two guys in the back, they deal so much damage. If only Waka had a bit more strength. Oh, god damn it. I have an idea though. Good dodge, Yuna. Good dodge, Yuna. I am going to block with you. I'm going to finish this guy off. I'm going to summon Veil for... Okay, so he's immune to that. Nice. Bum bada bum. Dum da dum. Hold up. My girlfriend is coming over today. But what time is she coming? Block for now. I'm gonna do the same thing as I did. Dude. This guy out of the way. Nice. Doesn't matter. Block. Tag that guy. Summon. Fail four. Yeah. I thought this was supposed to be shortened. This is not all that short. Come on,
please,
man.
Lend us your strength.
Shut up, Yuna. Just attack the thing. Please load this hit. Good. It's a lot of overdrive juice.
Oh my god, these cats are...
They opened up the curtains. Don't like it.
I can see the sun inside. I don't want to see the sun.
Get Bahamut and then try not to let him get killed and charge his overdrive as well. Should be able to take like one hit. I should be able to take two hits actually, unless he does Haymaker or whatever it's called now. Of course. Of fucking course. Oh my god, this is dumb. Oh well. Get this. Get that. Ifrit is ready. Fail 4 can't take a hit. Ixion should be able to take one hit from this guy. And I suppose I could, like, abuse the system of healing himself. Nice crit. Look at that. Charged. Don't kill me now. Good. Dismiss. Shiva's pretty weak in the physical defense side, so this might not be a good idea. Yep. Right. That's enough. Get back out there. let's finish this guy off with... darkness on him again, and then summon Veil for. Should be dead. Yep. Nice. So, no, Aeons, almost ready, ready, almost ready, not ready, because he fucking got wrecked. Shouldn't have gotten greedy on that one, but oh well. Actually, gonna block with you, dark with you. Armor break with you, and then summon Veil for, get his last bit of juice until he's ready. Which should be after this. Never mind. Fucking bullshit, man. Veil 4 is the worst. I hate Veil 4. He's so weak. Like, he's legit the weakest of them all. Which is kind of logical, but hey. Let me get cheese already. Hey. Yeah.
Go! Fight on!
Hey. Good. Miss. I'm gonna risk it. But I should be fine. Well, of course I'm fine, because it kill him. I hate grinding. Well, I hate grinding on stream, let me rephrase that. Stupid Overdrive Sin. Let me give Bahamut that last hit he needs. Because I feel Bahamut is more important than Veil 4 anyways.
Go! Fight on!
There we go. Dismiss. I want to use Veil 4 just... Oh, fucking hell, that does so much damage. As long as he has, hasn't got renewed Dark, I don't want to use him. Use Veil 4 yet. Dark, please affect him. Nice. Block with you. Summon Veil 4. Dismiss. I'm not gonna risk it because Veil 4 is like super frail. And just kill him. Nice. It's like 6,000 apiece. Yep. Seems Overdrive isn't ready yet. Riku. And that's it. And then Aeon's its only Veil 4. Yep. Yeah. Yeah. Crazy cat. Hey. Stop that. Not gonna summon just yet. I am going to kill his... This guy. His guy. Mm-hmm. With you. Doesn't matter. Kill him. Nice. Let's hope he doesn't get one shot. If he gets one shot, I'm gonna say fuck Veil 4 because I don't give a damn about him. He's weak as fuck anyways. Please live this. Good. Just finish this guy off. Good job. Alright, let's go try and beat Overdrive Sin again. Well, not again, but let's give it another shot, shall we? What are you doing with my curtains, man? Hey. Oh jeez, I almost pushed my phone off the sofa. Save. Stop it. For fuck's sake, Cloud. Alright, who do we want? We want Lulu, Waka, Yuna to start out. Lulu. Well, let me also... Can't watch the stream properly without Buffer, younger brother playing X360 takes a lot of the Wi-Fi. That's okay, man. Don't worry about it. All good. Come on. There we go. Stop it. Have a good one, losing. Hey! Well, Yuna's at a dead end currently. I'm gonna save on this safe sphere, because if I fail again, I don't want to run all the way back to Sid to go level more. Give this another shot, shall we? Let's see how we do. Summon Veil Fort. Cloud Genesis. Are you fucking shitting me now? This thing is out of range. Are you, this is the worst. Is this close enough? There we go, that's better. Yeah, that's damage cap. I don't know how good of an idea this is, now that I think about it. Because he's already halfway through his thingy. Wait, that was one overdrive. And he's halfway through his already. Let me do my overdrives with my other characters first as well. Fuck. God damn it. I don't think I'm even gonna worry about Kimari, because Kimari just does like 1500 damage. Yeah, this is not working out. This overdrive spam thing is not working out. Oh my god, I have no idea how to beat this fucking ass garbage thing. Fantasy X Overdrive Sin walkthrough. Let's see what this says about that. So that's 70,000, man. I don't have Anima. Like, come on, man. Grand Summon Bahamut. You know this is not working out. No critical. Incredible damage. Just per second, his magic is hard. He has a Grand Summon Bahamut. No more afterwards. Yeah, this fight is pretty much over already. Hey, Genesis, for fucking hell, man. Oh. Yeah. Turn by turn, one summon. At 16 turns, Sin's mouth will open completely. And use something and instant game over. Aeon's overdrives are useful in removing Sin's HP before it can destroy the player's party. Fluid can do so. Double casting flare or ultima. I don't have that. Armor break to make Sin vulnerable. Attacks with Tina should cast haste again on the party and use quick hit, which can run him several attacks in a row. It is possible to end the battle quickly by having Riku mix a trio of 99999. Wait until Sin is in range and use multi attack. Some Sin, such as Tina's walk, is overdrive. A strong anima overdrive can KO Sin in one hit. Alright, let me try something else. So formation. Waka with Tidus. Unit with Waka. Tidus. No. Arn Lua. Tidus Arn. Yeah, start with that. What? No. Why Arn? That doesn't make any sense whatsoever. Lulu. Lulu, Waka, Tidus, yes. The reason why I put R in there was because I was thinking of like the second half of the battle. So what I'm gonna try and do is Hastiga, Lulu with double cast, Waka with his shenanigans with the ball from distance. And once he gets close enough, switch Waka with Auron, cast haste on him, and then quick hit with Auron and Tidus to do as much damage as possible. And then when necessary, switch out Lulu for Yuna, and then spam Overdrive with summon Bahamut Overdrive, dismiss, grand summon Bahamut Overdrive. Let's see how that works. I don't think it's gonna work either, but all I can do is try, I guess. So, boy, magic haste to go. Put this on. I should have put the 1 MP sword on. What's his face? I can't even hit him with Waka. Are you fucking shitting me? Not even Waka, huh? Fine. Double cast. Firaga. White magic haste on him. Using ether on him. Just so he's maxed out for quick hit. Out, please. There. Now switch Auron. Actually, no, not switch Auron. Skill. Quick hit. Bad. Oh shit, I have to do armor break first. Damn it. Fuck. Well, it's over. That's all I can say now. It's over. Fucking bullshit, man. Ugh. This is annoying. Well. We can use a Mega Phoenix on these two idiots. Five 5,000 damage, which is basically the same. Try not to fuck this one up now. There we go. I'm gonna switch Lulu out for Yuna now. Next time it's Lulu's turn. Quick hit. Switch you for Yuna. Grand summon. No, not grand summon. Summon. Bahamut. Yeah, this is not gonna work. God damn it, man, this is just... Well, let's see, now his overdrive's ready, and I think that's like three more turns until it's over. Wow, not even. Okay. I have absolutely no idea what to do now. I don't know what to do. Give me a moment. How close it is to using overdrive? 140,000 damage worth of damage before the end. Sin will start off too far away. We'll slowly move closer to the remaining range as the battle progresses. Use the first few turns to enhance your characters using cheer luck. So I don't have to, you can't save the cat on the party. Lulu or walking your party with some damage at a distance. You should have Auron use armor break once and gets close enough. Alternatively, you can have Riku use remix ability. Two power spheres or two ability spheres creating a fragment each, which can cause armor break status damage. Sin will begin attacking your party once it gets close enough to the ship, so be prepared to deal with the petrified, confusing zombie status effect as they come. Good luck. Yeah. Status ailments. You don't have time to mess around in his belly. You need to do a lot of damage. You walk in 140,000 damage in a short amount of time. It's absolutely necessary. Have Tidus cast it on everyone if you get the chance. Otherwise, you just use. And Okay. Will be enough. After you are drawn to Sin for the third time, you will be within physical attack range. At this point, cast as many Aeon Overdrives or use Holy. Put the unit in Switcher out for Waka or Tidus. What's your question? Sorry. Yeah, I think I... There's legit nothing that I can think of right now other than to, like, level immensely so I deal massive, like... Even then, like, the damage cap is 9,999, so even if I hit that cap with, like... Auron and Yuna and Lulu and Tidus and potentially Waka, there's still no... So, yeah, I'm just gonna call it here because I have no idea what to do. I'm going to do some counseling with Nyasu when she wakes up again. And see what she has to say. Well, I'm gonna call it here. Thank you for everyone that hang out. And I will be back another time with this game, hopefully with progress.